It's the end of another worky week here at Loving Life 103.1. Time to talk real estate this morning. Alison Waits joins us in the studio. Good morning.
Good morning, Damo.
Easter is just around the corner. Is Easter a good time to try and put your house on the market and, you know, have it out there for potential investors?
Yeah, definitely. So every part of the year is fantastic to sell. But I always say around school holidays definitely is a great time to sell. We look at Christmas, we look at Easter, look at July holidays. People travel. People that are moving from town to town, they actually only get time off mostly is at school holidays. So what a fantastic time to do it. And also ask those agents, can I see it on a public holiday? Can I see it on a Sunday? Can I see it? Because that's my day off work.
Indeed. And I guess the important thing is if you are looking at putting your house on the market during the school holidays, to make sure you start to declutter now.
Yes, definitely. So whenever you can, I'm pretty sure there's going to be a council pickup shortly coming. So why not start culling your stuff? It is fantastic because the first impressions last. So as soon as somebody drives past your house, if it's an absolute mess and your garden's overgrown, first impressions not so good because then they'll think the inside of the house is just the same. And it also comes to the photos. Everything on social media and the websites is your first impressions. So if they see your photos that are decluttered, neat and tidy, not like a magazine, it doesn't have to be set that way, but it has to be lived in, like a house, but also just clean, tidy, move everything away, take away personal effects as well.
Why do you need to take away the personal effects?
It's always been a bit of an issue to, as an agent, that, you know, we've got photos of kids, we've got family photos. You know, you just don't want that on the website for people to see.
Sure.
Because they know what rooms are the kids' bedrooms.
Yep.
And, you know, things like that. So you just don't know. You just don't know who's looking as well.
Yeah.
So you've got to be careful when it comes to personal things and jewellery. And, you know, even though the agent is going to be with the person, with the buyers going through, if it's an open house and we've got 20 people through, we can't be in 20 places.
Yeah.
So it is wise to put your personal things away and also personal photos.
And you were saying before about, you know, making sure that the start of the house, the front of the house, from the garden back into the house is looking, you know, spick and span.
Yes.
So obviously, you know, look after your garden first and then start on the house. So
yes.
It may not be an overnight thing that you can just go, oh, we're going to put the house on the market, let's go. It's going to take some months of planning.
Definitely. And that's where you get extra money from as well. Because if your house is, you know, it's like a hoarder's house and it's messy and it's dirty, it's got cobwebs and, you know, like dead flies and bugs around and, you know, it's and the mould right now because obviously with all the floods, the houses are getting mouldy. So keep that under track, keep it clean and tidy because that's where the buyers will go in and go, oh, there's going to be issues structurally as well. There's going to be issues below the surface because you're not looking after your house. So to get the top dollar, make sure it looks beautiful. You know, just do your best. The agent can help you as well with that. Get a really good photographer because they will be able to help and get the buyers through.
Indeed. Some good tips on when and how to list your property. Make sure you do the decluttering first. Thank you. We'll see you at the same time next week.
See you next week. Our house.